And Yahoo Finance's Anjali Kamlani taking a break from coronavirus coverage for a moment and is joining us with a guest.
Thanks, Julie. Yes, I have here with me Nancy Erika Smith, partner at Smith Mullen, a firm in New Jersey, which famously helped to defend the women who were suing Fox for sexual harassment. So you've also now added to your list PNC Bank, and that recently got sorted out. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Yes. My client was assaulted by a customer at PNC who PNC had at least 3 years' notice was a sexual harasser. We claimed that it was entitled to a safe workplace, even from a customer, and even right outside the bank. The assault began in the vestibule and continued on the private sidewalk in front of PNC. The jury agreed with us and awarded her $2.4 million.
Wow. And so this is emblematic of really the awakening, right? We're talking about International Women's Month. There's the awakening of this outlet of as a resource of women really coming to the forefront and saying, I'm not going to stand for this anymore, and I need to find help. So are you finding that, you know, with the cases that you've already done, that you're seeing an increase really in interest?
There is no question that more women are saying, I don't have to tolerate this anymore. And one reason is that we're supporting one another more. You know, Me Too really makes a difference that if you're not alone. In individual organizations, we saw it at Google, we saw it at McDonald's, the first nationwide strike by women complaining about sexual harassment. We saw it in Mexico yesterday, a nationwide strike of women, not even in the public sphere, staying away from even mass transportation. If we did that around the world, we could really change the world. We're tired of, men are foremost. We live in a patriarchal society, all of us. And men are in the forefront, and protecting men is always the first goal. And we need to change that.
Do you think that it has helped as well? Obviously, you know, you have a character now. There have been people who have played you in both a show and a movie. So seeing that and seeing that sort of the entertainment industry role in that, what do you think their role really is in this?
Well, some of the worst perpetrators of sexist views of women come from the entertainment industry. So when Matt Lauer does a 12-minute skit making fun of sexual harassment, and Harvey Weinstein decides how women are portrayed in movies, and Les Moonves decides what's news, and Charlie Rose decides who's important to interview, all of us are affected by that. So the entertainment industry is going to be in the forefront of changing attitudes, and women coming into the entertainment industry and journalism. Women in journalism will change this, because shining the light of day on it is what has really changed things and really moved things along. When Gretchen Carlson first sued Roger Ailes, the media took notice. And that empowered other women to come forward and say, he harassed me too. We went back 5 decades of harassment by Roger Ailes. Same with Harvey Weinstein, Bill Cosby. Journalism, the media, is helping to empower women to come forward.
Is it really a role of, you know, who is a notable figure that's being sued? Or is it just everyday women can really take this on and still get the attention that's necessary?
And you asked me about that the last time we talked about PNC Bank. Yes, this was a wealth manager. You know, she made $85,000 a year. She wasn't a $1 million anchor. But she was important. Every one of us is important. Every one of us has to fight. She's made $2.4 million. The jury awarded her because of what happened to her. She was brave. It took years. It was tough. But she did it. And since then, other women at PNC and other banks have started calling and saying, wait a minute, I have a customer who's harassing me as well, and they won't do anything about it. So women are supporting one another, and that's really important. Every woman, not just famous women, not just famous perpetrators. We all need to stand up.
So this is one of those things where we really have to start hearing more about them as well. So what would you say to someone who is maybe in a professional environment about what they need to do?
What they need to do is don't go to HR. HR is never your friend. Go see a lawyer and see what your rights are. In many states, it's legal to tape record conversations without the other party's consent. They're called one-party consent states. New York is one. New Jersey is one. Some states, amazingly, do not allow that. So you can't record your sexual harasser harassing you. But getting legal advice is really the first step. going to HR is always a mistake. And I say that, I've been a lawyer for 40 years. Going to HR is a mistake. They're not your friend.
And that goes against exactly what the protocol is in companies. So,
exactly.
Yeah. Well, Nancy Erika Smith, partner at Smith Mullen, thank you so much for joining us today. Julie, back to you.